Hello friends and welcome to my YouTube channel. And today I'm going to talk about one general topic. Since a long time I was thinking to put some video on this, a YouTube learning a reality check. Okay, so currently what I'm seeing on YouTube is there are many channels coming up and they are teaching you JavaScript in 5 minutes, JavaScript in Hindi, React in Hindi, Node.js in 10 minutes, learn Node.js in Hindi in 10 minutes. So I was just thinking, why, first of all, why they are doing this? I mean, there may be many YouTubers like me. I'm not saying that I'm the great one. I just have a few subscribers and I just started my channel a few years back. My main objective of this channel was to teach something which a developer can understand and later he can do hands-on on that particular teachings. Here, I'm not teaching Node.js in 10 minutes, React.js in 5 minutes, 15 minutes, or maybe 1 hour. Because these things, you can just get started from YouTube, but you can't learn these things with just a small span of period. So here, I just wanted to do a reality check, what actually you should target. If you are looking at the YouTube learnings, then what you should target, because obviously YouTube is a free platform and from here you can learn a lot of things, which I agree, because I am myself also posting some of the videos for the developers like you and developers like me to learn few new things. Either it is a framework, either it is a programming language, either it is a ORM, any particular technology which we talk about. Okay, but why I'm putting this video is you have to do the reality check if you are looking for some particular learning on YouTube. Are you getting enough by looking any particular video which is in Hindi? Okay, learn React.js in Hindi. If you just Google it out and try to see this, there are lot many channels who are teaching you things are Hindi, right? So do you think you can get an advantage by learning things in Hindi? First of all, even I got suggestions on my YouTube channel that I should teach in Hindi. I am not against Hindi. Hindi is our mother tongue as an Indian, but like learning these professional language framework in Hindi is not a suitable choice. I mean, you should target something at a professional level when you are going to be in any startup or any company. I'm not talking about MNCs and big enterprise. Now you can get easily job as a freelance. If you are good at your communication, you can just get a job in a basic startup where they are building the products, right? Learning things in Hindi doesn't make a sense, right? You should target the primary language is English. You are getting graduate from either bachelor degree in the technologies or any computer science branch. You are learning everything in English. Now, why you want to learn things in Hindi? And I don't know why people started teaching these technical courses in Hindi. Like learn React in Hindi, learn Node.js in Hindi. Everything is in Hindi available. Yes, maybe indirectly you are helping those developers by teaching things in Hindi, but indirectly you are not. Don't make things in Hindi, then you will come up with any other local language, Urdu, maybe Tamil, maybe any other local regional language, right? So you are not going to help developers by teaching these languages, because we at the end of the goal is we are not building the products for your local vendors, your local shopkeeper. You are not building the product for them. If you are working in MNC or some good company, then you are building the product for the clients. That clients can be from any country. And the primary language, the international business language which we have is the English, not Hindi. That is my one part. Another part is learning things from YouTube where people are teaching in Hindi, very basics. Like they are teaching you ABCD. You are a programmer, right? You are writing code. If you want to learn ABCD from the YouTube, then you are not at the good place. First, learn things from very beginner, very basics, how to write code, right? Then you start learning these frameworks and all these things. What people do is they will put a thumbnail like, okay, React, learn Node.js in 15 minutes, learn React.js in 10 minutes. And what people do, people start jumping in, they think, okay, in 10 minutes I can learn everything. Which I took to this 2.5 years or 3 years of experience. I myself not have a good core in-depth understanding of the internals, React internals. And you start putting a thumbnails, I mean some of the people start putting thumbnails, okay, learn React in 15 minutes. There you are giving a false promise to those who are going to view your videos. Yes, you will start teaching them, okay, how to do the installation, how to write the Hello World component, and then you are just stopped, because at that moment you are looking for more subscribers, more viewerships, right? I'm not saying that my YouTube channel has that huge number of subscribers. I don't want that, and YouTube is not my platform to earn money. I have other different source to earn these things, right? I just wanted to help developers. So even if any developer is coming to my channel and learning something, I will suggest that you should assess first, are you going to get something from this channel? Are you going to get some new technology from in-depth, from beginners? Okay, and first of all, don't learn things in Hindi, and don't get into a false promises where a particular YouTuber will come and they will just start showing you Hello World in Python, then just write some few lines of code in 5-6 videos, and then says, okay, you are now an expert in Python, now you are an expert in JavaScript. Here you see that React in 10 minutes, right? 5 minutes, 10 minutes. I don't know what these people are teaching, but you can think about it. Right, you can't learn things in 10 minutes, 5 minutes, 15 minutes. You need an expertise. Even if you are watching something in depth, what you need is, YouTube is just a platform which may teach you at a beginner level how to get started. At the end goal is, you should learn things by your own practice, because coding is something, programming is something, either you write Python, Java, JavaScript, you will get mature enough, you will get expertise once you write. And expertise comes over the time. It's not like you just start learning something today and after 5 days you become expert in that. It will never happen. I mean, whatever your IQ level and whatever you can contain in your brain, right? There is always a capacity we have, and there is always a limit which you can learn in a particular day. You can't learn everything in a single day or a single week. There are few things which is called coding and expertise or experience which comes over the time. A simple developer who knows HTML, JavaScript, coming and starting video React.js, learned React.js in 30 minutes. He said that I'm good, now I can write React application. Now he's appearing maybe in the interviews and just answering the questions. That may be a beneficial if he's able to crack the job, but it's not the right way. You will be able to face one day, okay, you don't know core JavaScript, how it works, the core internals of JavaScript, and you end up learning React.js and you know nothing. You just learned from bits and pieces of React.js, and now you are realizing that you haven't done a good job. You just fallen into a false trap of these YouTubers who are promising you, okay, learn this in Hindi and all these things, right? So they might be creating these Hindi channels just to target the Hindi audience, but for professional language, Hindi is not the right choice. I used to speak Hindi with my family and my friends. I'm proud of being a Hindi language speaker. It's my mother tongue. But don't include that in your professional career. Even at least for these technical courses which we have, try to keep that in the English only, and just try to behave professionally and try to learn the professional language, because you're not going to speak with the clients in Hindi to explain React framework or Angular framework or any other thing. Okay, so just do a reality check of any learnings which you have done on YouTube. Try to learn the quality content. There are many good YouTube channels available on the YouTube. I'm not talking about mine, and I'm not doing publicity of my YouTube channel. There may be a lot many YouTube channels who have like millions of subscribers and teaching good things. So try to assess what you are getting from that YouTube channel. Is it a good learning, or it is just only for sales and marketing? What people do is, they launch a YouTube channel and then they start doing a sales and marketing of their own private courses which they are teaching. So YouTube is a free platform and you can get everything free. It's not a Udemy platform where you see only 10 videos and start purchasing their paid videos. Okay. Till now I published all these courses playlists from beginner to end level. So if you are starting with something, first I will suggest, don't jump into any framework. Learn basic fundamentals of programming, then come to basic fundamentals of JavaScript. Then once you are good enough with the JavaScript, then you should learn what are the basics of web development, HTML, CSS, SAS and all. then start learning these frameworks. Okay, React is popular, Angular is there, Vue.js is there, many other frameworks are there which can help you to get job, to build your career, where you can also teach others. It's not like you watch 30 minutes video and go to interview, get the job and then start being a champ, right? That will not help you. Okay, so this is all I wanted to tell you in this video. If you are watching it, then just think about it, what you are learning from YouTube. Just try to learn from the good technical source. You can also have a books, You Don't Know JS. That is one of the good source for learning JavaScript, the internals. There may be front end masters, I will suggest. If you really wanted to pay something and learn something, front end masters for JavaScript developers is the best website where you are going to get something really good. Okay, thanks everyone.